If you ask the question as to what percentage of people in this country are able to get justice through our judicial system, the honest answer would be not even 1%. The reason is that 80% people cannot even access the judicial system because they don't have lawyers, they can't afford lawyers, without whom you cannot access such a procedurally complex system which has been put in place. Secondly, those who can even afford lawyers, they have to struggle in courts for decades before their case gets decided. And even when the case comes to be decided, it is often decided because of incompetence or because of corruption, it's wrongly decided, and eventually, in my view, not even 1% people are able to get justice through this system. In order to set the system right, we first need to simplify it so that people can access the system without the help of lawyers. This can be done by making the procedure simple, by providing people with some paralegal help, etc., in the courts, which the state can do. Secondly, we need to speed up the disposal of cases, which will be helped by making the procedure simple, but also by increasing the number of judges and the number of courts in our system, which the law commissions have been recommending, but the government has not been doing that. Thirdly, we need to improve the system of selection and appointment of judges. We need to make it more transparent, more broad-based, more credible, so that the right kind of people, better people, get selected as judges. And lastly, we need to put in a system of judicial accountability by which errant judges, judges who misconduct themselves, can be against whom complaints can be received, and they can be disciplined or removed on the basis of those complaints by a credible independent examination. However, nobody, the government nor the judiciary, is really interested in bringing about these fundamental changes in our system, because both the government and the judiciary are happy with the existing system. It is only the consumers of justice, the ordinary citizens, who are the real stakeholders in a judicial system, who are being affected by it and who need to come together to form another movement for judicial reforms, where they will need to get together and bring about a campaign on the same lines as the anti-corruption movement. We need to have a campaign for judicial reforms which should call for all these things that I have mentioned. This is something which can be done if people get together, and which is a crying need of today.